In that video, you are going to learn how to create a blur effect in Android by using the RenderScript features. On Android, you can use RenderScript computation framework through the RenderScript support library API. You must configure your development environment and using at least Android SDK tools revision 22.2 or higher and Android SDK build tools revision 18.1.0 or higher. Then you must use the version 8 support library that contains the version 8 RenderScript library. In your build Gradle file, add the two properties, RenderScript target API et RenderScript support mode enabled, set to true. Note that the support library classes for RenderScript library are in package android.support.v8.renderscript. Now, it's time to create the blur builder class with a static blur method that will be called to blur an image passed in parameter. So, create the new class named blur builder. We start by creating a constant named bitmap scale. Use it to adjust the bitmap scale as you want for the initial image. We set the radius value of the blur effect. Supported range is between 0 and 25. Now we create the blur method that takes the context in parameter and the bitmap to blur. In return, it produces the bitmap blurred. We calculate the new width and height by applying the bitmap scale factor to the image passed in parameter. We create the scaled image thanks to the bitmap create scaled bitmap static method. Then we can create the output bitmap with the static create bitmap method. Now it's time to create an instance of RenderScript. Now you can use the intrinsic Gaussian blur filter coming from the RenderScript library. The class is named script intrinsic blur and takes in parameter the RenderScript context. Don't forget to import the version 8 RenderScript package. Then we need to allocate memory from the allocation create from bitmap method for the input bitmap and the output bitmap. Now we can set the radius for the blur effect by passing in parameter the blur radius constant. Then we set the input for the intrinsic Gaussian blur filter. We apply for each on the output bitmap. And then can copy from memory allocated to the output bitmap instance. And we have just to return the new bitmap created with the blur effect applied. Now we have to define a layout with two image view, set an image on the first image view, apply the blur effect in this image, then displaying the result in the second image view to compare the result of the effect. So it's a simple layout. We choose dimensions. We define the source. Don't forget to center horizontally the image. We will use the SSorels apps logo and we create the image view result. Placed just below the initial image. Last step is to change the main activity to apply the blur effect on an image and display the result. We need to get the image view instance for the original image. For the result image, sorry. We create the result bitmap. And we will use the blur builder blur static method applied on the logo SSorel apps got from the decode resource static method. So we have the result bitmap in result bitmap instance. So we can apply on the result image view set image bitmap. And now it's time to test the effect on the emulator. It can take some time to build the project. We need to wait. Gradle build is running. First build is always longer. The APK is installing on the emulator. The application is starting. And so you can see the initial image on the top of the screen and the result image at the bottom with the blur effect applied. We can change the initial spacing and the bitmap scale, for example. Click on run and see the change applied with instant run functionality. Can see the result, and so the blur effect is applied. Simple and efficient effect.